Welcome to the Feel Good Place. I'm Dr. Dar, your host and Feel Good Alchemist. If you are a people pleaser who wants to thrive in your life, work, and relationships, and generally you love contributing to make the world a better place. Full disclosure, these are recordings from my Facebook Lives, and there's lots of inspiration here for you. Enjoy and reach out, drop me a comment, and I look forward to connecting with you on the other side. So, happy Friday. Wow, this month is just really trucking along, isn't it? We are halfway through the month, and we are just in a new lunar cycle. If you didn't join the new moon planning call, every month we will be doing a planning session that is more holistic and integrated. It's more focused so that we focus on your desired outcomes for the year, what you want to have happen in your life. It's more of a state of being and a state of feeling as opposed to doing and filling our time up so full that our wisdom, inner wisdom and energy and alignment doesn't happen. So that's what we're playing with there. Today, I want to pull from my Sacred Wealth card deck. I just felt like it was appropriate for us to be talking about money. I also did a money workshop. I did a word of the year and money workshop late in December last year to pick our word for the year. And I talked about money. Money in and of itself doesn't have any energy. Sure, it passes hands, you know, when I'm talking about the tangible cash or even electronic money, it passes through systems which have energy, but by the time it comes to us, we give it energy, you know, through how we earned it, through who we worked with, how they treated us, how we feel or our attitude as we're paying our bills. When a check comes in, do you just immediately mindlessly deposit it? Or, you know, there's just a lot of different ways that we dismiss money and disrespect it. I know I certainly have. I was a consummate consumer, and any extra that I would have, instead of putting it in my having account, which I call savings instead of saving, I call it a having account, and I just set it and forget it. And that's different from my investment account. I would spend it. And that was endemic or indicative of something missing inside of myself, seeking something, proving something, unresolved energy. And when I started looking at it, rather than trying to figure out why I was doing it, during a new moon cycle, I chose a different behavior. And the different behavior was around really connecting with how I feel. There's just a lot, there's a lot wrapped up around money and love. You know, we in this community as Feel Goodesses, as givers, we don't want to be greedy. We don't want to, you know, we like to share, we like to give. But when it comes to money, we end up in a place of lack or scarcity or fear or anxiety around this thing called money. And I just want to share with you that in and of itself, it doesn't have any energy. So what if when someone hands you some cash or gives you a check, you just sat there and observed it for a moment and just simply expressed gratitude and appreciation and looked at it, and then visually invited it to multiply, like just multiply. Wouldn't that be incredible? I am implementing this practice in my life right now. Any amount of money that comes in, I just do a little short meditation. the meditation is simple. I'll give you some words just as an example. Wow, look at this beautiful check, this money that I've received. Money is so beautiful. It's freeing, it's gorgeous, and it's full of just so much love in what it can do. And I'm the one that gives it energy. I also, that was not the meditation. I'm tuning in. Okay, so going into meditation now. So just imagine you received a payment for a service that you provided, because all of us are service providers in this community. Just look at it. Imagine the person that gave it to you. Maybe they're in front of you, and just look at them with gratitude. Thank you so much for this reciprocal gift or exchange for my services. I'm so grateful. And then as you carry it in your wallet, don't just shove it in there. Put it in a special place. Visualize it going into a special place in your wallet so that when you get home and you pull it out, or many of you are at home already like me, pull it out and look at it. And just gaze at it. And notice what comes up. Nothing may come up. You might feel some stuff in your body. Just notice it. Just observe it. And when you're ready, just look at that money and just say, I'm grateful. I'm so appreciative of having this. And universe, please cause this. Please create the space for this to be multiplied. Let me move to a state of having all that I desire in the form of the energy of money. Let me be in a place of peace and love and joy with money. Money is honey, it is ambrosia, and it is my sovereign right, as it is for all sentient beings. And then visualize that check. Just visualize 10 to 12 of the 12 of them on your desk. Maybe they're different dollar amounts. And just feel into what it's like to have that. You know, this idea of receiving is, a place of it on the way and being open to having. So receiving is really being open as a container for having. So as you visualize those 12, 15, 50 checks on your desk, notice what's happening in your body. Notice if anything around worth is showing up, anything around esteem is showing up. And if you're in a place of just grounded neutrality, like there's nothing there and you're not feeling any heaviness, that's where you want to be. And just smile, bow your head in gratitude. That's just one way. That's just what came through. And fascinating, pulling from my sacred deck card, sacred wealth card, the leader, sun. Notice how it's Canadian geese flying into the sun. I lead from the heart. The words, the keywords associated with I lead from the heart, and by the way, the leader is associated with the planet or the luminary, the sun. Confident, brilliant, purposeful, courageous, committed, authentic, positive, inspiring, passionate, empowered, visionary, vital, integrity, it says integrous, and trustworthy. it's interesting that this card is coming up because we, as women and as givers, we really are being called to be the leaders with our money and with our wealth. And I invite you to just take a look at I'm looking for the reading from the card. It's actually the first card in the deck. So I invite you to look at where you can lead, be more, you know, be more of these keywords, qualities around money, you know, confident around money instead of this fear and lack space that we've been trained to have over eons. Being brilliant with your money, being purposeful with your money, being courageous with your money, being committed with your money, being authentic with your money, being positive with your money, being inspiring with your money, being passionate with your money and wealth, being empowered with your money and wealth, being a visionary with your money and wealth, knowing that it's vital, being in integrity and trustworthy with your money. It's just, the mantra is, I lead from the heart. The sole desire is to live up to your highest potential and guide others to theirs for the greatest good of all. So aligned with how we live in this world, in this community, and in our worlds. The purpose is to live in the present, free from the past, and to create an ideal future. Oh boy, I needed this message. You know, with the superpower, the feel-good energy tracker, yesterday, let's see, yeah, today and tomorrow are a water day. These 3 days have a lot of water energy, and I'm just noticing elementally when water energy is present, it's very emotional, and feelings of scarcity and doubt and lack can seep in on those days. Water signs do really well during these days. I am an air sign, so water day stuff comes up. I invite you to get the tracker so that you can start tracking for yourself and you can see what's happening elementally, energetically on our planet, because we are influenced by it. You know, a client asked me yesterday, why am I just constantly in tears today? Well, it's a water day, and you have a lot of Virgo analytical energy. You also have a lot of Capricornian energy, and water days can feel very wonky. Oh, is that all it is? Yeah. And it just helps us deal or manage with our emotional waves much easier when we understand that there's other energies supporting our wisdom and growth and expansion. So when I start getting teary, I look at my tracker and I'm like, oh, okay, this is what's going on elementally. Let me just sit with it now. It passes, or I go through it much quicker, because there's a deeper level of understanding that we are not alone in it, that there are energies on our planet and in our world that we're all participating in and we're all influenced by. And it just brings this inner peace of mind and this wash of calm over me when I recognize, oh, it's a water day, and I've had these, you know, feelings of doubt or lack or things showing up. And when I see that it's a water day, talking about my experience with the tracker and how it works for my energy. Yours is unique to you, which is why it's important to track. And, you know, I'm very congested right now, so bear with me. I'm going to be clearing it a little bit. with the water energy, it's really unique to you and how you express it and how it shows up for you. But for me, you know, knowing it's started for me yesterday. I started having these doubts and questions and the desire to pivot or change direction or, you know, get on my website and change it up or, you know, go and change something because I'm not getting the results I'm looking for versus staying the course. I know on those water days, I've just got to stay the course and understand that those doubts or those feelings of lack or scarcity are really messages for me, and there's wisdom for me in that. And if I just sit through it, there's going to be something incredible that happens when I come out of it. Following that, there's going to be some fire days. So if I just give myself the space to do things that bring me joy, or just be and not stay, you know, so busy, that when we come out of the water day, there's going to be some pretty incredible things that happen around productivity, getting things done, things showing up in my life. So, you know, honor you, do you, track what's going on for you, and do get yourself a copy of this tracker. It's amazing. It will change your life. Okay, so the shadow side of the leader is, and this is another way that you can lead and manage your energy, which I'm a big fan of. Today, you'll notice probably that I'm very congested. My energy's a little bit drained. So after this, I have a call with a client, and then I'm probably just going to chill for a bit. I may just go and walk just to help clear up the congestion. I also noticed that on water days, the congestion tends to show up, which is interesting. So, you know, just notice what happens for you on these days. I should tell you a little bit about the tracker. The tracker provides you with the moon phases, and is connected to our full moon and new moon parties that we have in this community. It also tells you what element is present in the day. There's also a way to find out what your elemental makeup is from an astrology perspective, so that you can take a look at what, you know, how your energy interacts with the elemental energy of the day. And I'll also be, at some point later this year, be bringing more astrology related information into this community, just not from an astrological perspective, even though it's connected to that, but really from an energy perspective of managing our energy so that we can be whole, complete, fulfilled, and succeed. So I'll be doing some of that as well. Okay, so the leader reading is an inspiring, confident, purposeful person with the clarity to courageously lead others towards a better future. As a leader, you embody the true essence of leadership in that you guide by example and teach others to lead themselves. Boy, if that is not an affirmation for me, it absolutely is an affirmation for me. I am all about walking my talk and you know, partner with people who are that way as well. And definitely am the model for that. You have a vision, therefore you can help others create a vision and inspire them to align with your goals and their goals. You are brilliant, heart-centered, and lead from the inside out by tapping into divine guidance, trusting your intuition, and being an authentic expression of your most valued gifts and talents. You are passionate about developing people and know that true fulfillment comes from genuinely being valued. You expertly build a secure structure where your team is using their most valued gifts to achieve more than they believe is possible while contributing to the success of the whole. You've united them and now they are committed to moving your mission forward as if it was their own. So this is something I'm just sitting with. You know, I was very much a leader in organizations and when I had the J-O-B, as I call it. And now I'm looking at what does being a leader at home and in my business look like? And what does my team look like? So I think this is a message to just sit with that over the next couple of days and see what shows up. Now, the shadow side of the leader. You are better than most at what you do, but if you let it go to your head, your ego will stroke you into arrogance. You can become addicted to power and delude yourself into thinking that power and responsibility are yours and yours alone. We're certainly seeing this in the world. When you are stressed, you can be over-controlling. When this happens, it may feel impossible for your team to trust you or be led by you. You will literally squeeze the life out of your mission. If you find yourself in the shadow of the leader, you've lost your connection to source and put your ego in charge. It's time for a serious break to get back to the roots of whatever spiritual practice keeps you tuned in and present. The high value gifts of the leader archetype, presence, problem solving, has a big vision, authenticity, decisive, listens, creates a supportive environment for success, consistent and trustworthy, leads by example, clearly communicates, inspires others to action, sees others' strengths, and magnetizes alignment with mission. So, you know, what do you see in me around those words? What do you see in yourself around these words? I'm curious. So, I actually would love to hear from you as to your experience of me as a leader of this community. You know, I'm going to be taking this on. Presence, check. Problem solving, check. Big vision, check. Authenticity, check. Decisive, most of the time, except on water days. Listens, check. Creates a supportive environment for success, check. Consistent and trustworthy. Trustworthy, yes. Consistency, for those of you who have been in this community for a while, I am still working on that as I figure out what would be the most value in this community, for managing our energy and feeling good about our lives and embracing our feel-good vibe and having structures that support us. Leads by example, check. Clearly communicates, yep. Inspires others to action, yeah. Sees others' strengths, oh yeah. And magnetizes alignment with mission. Still working on that one. So, yeah, this is very cool. I also go through the archetypes of the planets and the luminaries in the tracker too. And I'll drop a link to the tracker here in this post so that you can go check it out and get your copy. The Inspired Action Plan. I practice presence to be divinely aligned with my high-value gifts and live into my greater potential while courageously leading others to theirs. That is really beautiful. So the Sacred Wealth Code of the Leader. Now, the wealth codes, I don't feel like we only have one. I think what I may do is pull from this card deck maybe every Friday. There's not a whole lot of cards in here, but eventually we'll go through all of them and then you can pick which one's aligned for you. Let me know if that's something you're interested in and we'll do it. This deck is by Prema Lee Guerrieri and it's just awesome. So I think we're all being called to be leaders as women of our wealth, and that's our inner and outer wealth. That's it for today. Have a beautiful, beautiful weekend, and go with wealth, sacred wealth, sovereign.